Good morning, afternoon, and evening, citizens of Analdoran and across our beloved empire. It's great to be in the empire yet again today. Thank you guys so much for stopping by the biggest and deadliest Star Destroyer, where we gotta talk about another Star Destroyer that's big, maybe not quite as big and deadly as ours here. The Executor, and believe it or not, I know we've been getting 7-star commander titles, but at the same time, we've been getting some 7-star Razor Crest lurking around out there, with one being yours truly. We're going to show lots of gameplay of a 7-star Razor Crest, a little bit on my thoughts, but also in this video, we got some new intel and information on the Executor, how it's going to be unlocked, more details on that, and a little bit of another tidbit, there are no more challenge ranker raids or even challenge raids in general coming anytime soon. Let's go ahead, roll some footage of this bad boy right behind us. Long story short, with this guy, not much of a material difference from 5 stars to 7 stars, but obviously needed to get the Executor. Hits a little bit harder, a bit more durable, and I think it's gonna be a much bigger important. It's gonna have a much bigger role in the future of ships with the addition of the Executor. I'm that bombshell of the Executor. Let's start our conversation off with that. So in the road ahead, last week that we broke down, they announced that the Executor was coming to Star Wars Galaxies, and they used this term, Journey Guide, Fleet Mastery. And when you hear the word Journey Guide, you think of something like, you know, General Anakin Skywalker, a Jedi Knight Luke Skywalker, or even Grand Admiral Thrawn's Chimera inside of the event. However, it's a little deceiving with how you're going to unlock it, but Crumb did a little bit of a teaser on Twitch. He just started streaming on Twitch. I'll leave a link down below. He streams and raises money for charities out there, so be sure to check him out. And he sometimes drops little hints here and there of stuff around the corner. So let's go ahead, cue this. And this comes from Reddit. They repost this. Bahia03 repost this on Reddit in case you missed it. Crumb shares exclusive information on how the Executor will be unlocked. Crumb, tell us all about it.
But there you go. There's your seven stars. Are you allowed to say if Executor is a full unlock right away, or does he have a timed element? Advanced Fleet Mastery into the Journey Guide is different than others. I believe he has a timed element. I don't think it's a full unlock right away. I think it'll kind of come and go as a couple events, if I remember correctly. But there you go. There's your exclusive for today.
There you go. So it's not going to be an unlock like the Chimera, despite the name of it being the Journey Guide Fleet Mastery. It sounds like it's going to be exactly like how Holdo's ship or Hux's Finalizer is going to be operating, where you need to have 7-star units to unlock the ship. And then over the course of many months, you slowly garner the blueprints to get the capital ship to 7 stars. And there's a few things I want to talk about that. Man, I am not a huge fan of the Fleet Mastery events, mainly because even after they've been out for multiple years, they don't make it any easier to expedite the process of getting a character. Unlike other journey events, like just Jedi Knight Luke Skywalker, just the other day, a couple weeks ago, he was finally added permanently to the journey event guide. So you can go in there, get him, and you don't have to wait. I understand fine with these Fleet Mastery events. Okay, fine. Bring them in and maybe have it where after a year, then they become a little bit easier to farm, and because now he's not as exclusive anymore. So unfortunately, it seems like it's gonna be like that. You're not gonna be able to outright unlock this capital ship at 7 stars, and I'm guessing they haven't confirmed it. Just like Holdo's Raddus or Hux's Finalized, you might be able to refresh the event multiple times to unlock the ship or even get it to 7 stars all the way forward. And with that in mind, there's one more little tidbit you need to know about the Executor here. It was not quite evident in the first road ahead that they released, but they clarified that a 5-star Razor Crest is not going to allow you to complete the event. They had to update that section right here to say that a 7-star Razor Crest is going to be needed, as well as all these other ships, at 7 stars if you want to completely get the event accomplished. And what does that mean? A 7-star Razor Crest is going to be quite the grind. However, they did say they're going to be releasing details on how they'll make the Razor Crest a bit more accessible to farm, now that it's not the newest and shiny toy in the Conquest toy box. And let's start talking about the Razor Crest, because I've been getting a lot of questions about it. It's been kind of overshadowed by Commander Ahsoka Tano. She was the big deal. She's the hot topping. And the Razor Crest, although a decent ship now, not as impactful as Commander Ahsoka Tano is now. However, with the Executor being designed
to be a bounty hunter capital ship to lead the charge. I'm thinking this is going to be a much more important ship down the road. Obviously, you're seeing us use the Chimera with the Razor Crest right now, and it's gotten the job, you know, kind of done all right for the most part. You don't really see a lot of people use it to counter the top-end meta fleets, but you've seen yours truly use it a lot in Grand Order to counter things like the Holdo, sometimes an Empire fleet. It seems to work comfortably in there, but with the 7-star Razor Crest, before the Executor comes into the picture, there's really only three main things you gotta notice. It's a little bit faster. The higher the star count you get, the faster your ship is gonna be. It definitely puts a decent hits out here and there, and on top of it, it is a much more durable ship than its 5-star variant that we tested out a few months ago. Otherwise, ever since our 5-star review, more or less we're kind of accomplishing the same thing, although I do have some of the same complaints that I mentioned before. I wish the buff community was a bit more consistent on the stalling strafe ability that he has. When I need the buff community, it never happens. In the footage you're seeing, I maybe got buff community once out of the whole entire time I had, and it would have been nice if it had a locked buff community stance, but otherwise, not that crazy different from its 5-star variant that we saw a while ago. But with the Executor being promised as a bounty hunter ship, and the developers on their podcast interview they did last week on the Gambit podcast, I believe, they did state, and I quote, that they expect this ship to sit well at the top of the meta, the Executor Bounty Hunter fleet, that is. So this sounds like a ship you're gonna wanna shoot for if you care about top spots in Fleet Arena, or you wanna maintain your competitive edge with fleets inside of Grand Arena. It's definitely gonna be important. I get this question a lot. Should I focus on Master Kenobi now, or should I focus on the Executor? We're taking into subject that the Executor will be a competitive top-end fleet, but right now Master Kenobi is so dang good, and Galactic Legends, especially with this vision that CG has and how important Galactic Legends are. They want to maintain their raid boss status and pretty much be untouchable by the peasant characters in Star Wars Galactus. If you're someone on that fence, should you go for Master Kenobi? Should you go for Executor? Master Kenobi is what's here and what's right here right now, and it's so dang good. If you had to decide, I would go for Master Kenobi, but there seems to be a promise, I say that lightly, that Executor will be important down the run, and there's a lot of benefits to ships, and we're still waiting on what the ship load of content is meant to be for Star Wars Galaxies around the corner. Ships has not been that important in the game, but it is important if you want to try to get some crystals. If you can't be competitive in the squad arena, Fleet Arena is going to be the best alternative for you guys. And as you know, with this Executor, with these journey guide like requirements, it's going to be steep. It's going to be a long time. With this news that it's going to be more like a Raddus or a finalizer event where it's going to take a long time to unlock, keep that in mind. I think there's one more note I want to put about that Executor. Since we have Lord Vader coming around the next 4 or 5 weeks here, we have September coming in a couple weeks here, they announced that Lord Vader will be coming around the corner here in September. I think this pretty much confirms that we're not going to have the Executor as the requirements. If they were going to make the Executor requirements, they probably should have released it about 2 weeks ago or so at minimum to get people to start chasing after it. With less than a month, 5 weeks, and we still don't even know when the Executor is going to come to the game, I feel fairly confident if there is going to be a capital ship required for Lord Vader himself, probably not going to be the Executor. One more note I want to put in personally. There's no news, there's no data mines or anything like that, but I really hope we at least get the punishing one for Dengar, especially since he is kind of an important part to getting the Executor. You need a Relic 5 Dengar. It would be nice if they released the punishing one to really branch out this Executor Bounty Hunter fleet, which will have tons of Bounty Hunter synergies, and I really am excited to see how the Razor Crest and the Bounty Hunters will operate in this future meta, because they've been kind of working over a bunch of random capital ships. It'd be nice to see what a capital ship more designated towards bounty hunter traits and actually supports them instead of the other round where the bounty hunter ship has to support a capital ship that has no loyalty to the bounty hunters. We'll have to wait and see. So the Razor Crest, although 7 stars, it seems all right and dandy. If there was no Executor, I would say, you know what, there's not a huge reason to push for it. Now with the Executor comes to the game, bounty hunter fleets are probably gonna be a bit more meta, especially since we're seeing random fleets like the Chimera with a bunch of random bounty hunters stay fairly competitive with Negotiators and Malevolences. I think we can make a safe assumption that the Executor will help the bounty hunters be a lot more competitive up against top end fleets, and especially when people got to get Relegate Boba Fett's. We'll have to wait and see how that's going to look in the grand picture of things. Now, there's one more thing I almost forgot to mention before we head on out here. We got to talk about challenge raids. Now, there is a little bit of uncertainty going on in the game. What is going to be like the next direction of content? And we got the confirmation about 2 months ago or so that the developers have no plans anytime soon, the foreseeable future, on releasing a new raid, a Rancor raid, AAT raid, Sith Trumpet raid. No plans in regards to that, which left us a little bit confused and puzzled. what's the future going to be? Right now, honestly, obviously, Conquest is a bit of the newer kid on the block. It's still kind of trying to grow its legs and try to get its roots going in the Galaxy of Heroes community. And it's one of those game modes where it seems like they're trying to make sure it grows and develops as rosters develop out there. But we know the developers seem to turn their eyes away from raids, especially with all the time they put into the game. And it gets beaten so quickly due to progression in the game with new characters, gear, relics, yada, yada, yada. It seems like they don't even have plans for any more challenge raids down the road. Another snippet from Crumb's stream that we're going to roll right here. Gary, can you hit that for me, baby?
I'm like, no.
That's okay. Challenge tiers. I think, you know, we tried that. We had some ideas around it. I don't know if it was, you know, as successful as we wanted to. I think the pit's going to stay around. It's fine. It's doing what it needs to do, but it didn't do it didn't hit all the marks we wanted it to hit. So I think probably not going to do challenge tier stuff in the future. We may revisit it later. But
a running joke because it's like, oh god, so that means we're going to get a challenge Sith raid.
Oh, of course, right? Like you think that's logical progression, but you know, not right now.
Yeah. Not right now. So. Again, it really makes you wonder what's the future going to look like. Now, keep in mind, the challenge pit rancor rate is definitely endgame, mega endgame content. But again, when developers put all this effort in, they don't like game modes that they put months and time in. Developing a new raid, or even heck, maybe tuning up an old raid, and it gets beaten really, really quickly. They seem to like more game modes like Grand Arena or Conquest that naturally grow and are easy to tweak as the times change. So if you were expecting with Relic Knight around the corner that maybe they were going to give us a challenge AAT raid or Sith Tremor raid, nah, it seems like that's not even going to in the future, which really begs the question, what the heck is in the future? What is going to be the next big game mode? All we know is that there's a shipload of content coming. Is that going to be finally a Death Star event of some sort? We have a lot to figure out, but in the meantime, until then, make sure you hit that like button. Thank you guys for stopping by. Comment down below on your thoughts of a 7-star Razor Crest, your thoughts on the Executor, and heck, maybe your thoughts on, whoa, where's this future of Galaxy of Heroes going with new content in the game? Thank you so much for stopping by. Make sure you subscribe so you're not missing a thing. And always remember, oh, it's great to be in the Empire today. Larry, Gary, show our audience out the door, and I'll see you guys later. Peace out.